Sure, Alex. Okay, Wade.
So got a sale today. Another private
You didn't make any
one-on-one.
money, did you?
I did, Uncle Claude. I did.
Whoa. How much? Can we
Yeah.
round numbers if it's not too personal?
15 up front and then another 15 spread out over 6 months.
$15. That'll buy you 2 gallons of gas in California. That's great.
No, 15K, 15K.
Give him a round.
So,
Is that
but
the
I
sec
almost,
that is the
well,
second best way to start a Monday?
yeah, no, no, it was awesome. But I gotta be honest, man, I almost botched the sale. And one thing that I now realize that I have been doing that I need to like switch is sales call was on Thursday, and it was, hey, they basically gave me the I'll think about it, even though I started the call with, you're not going to tell me you'll think about it kind of thing. They still gave it to me. And I said, okay, well, I need you to get back to me by noon because this is one of the final one-on-one spots, which it is. That wasn't BS.
Okay, a little scare,
And
little scarcity. Good move.
yep. So she got back to me. She sent me a text message that same evening and basically said, look, we got some debts we got to pay off. Let's revisit in 3 months. I said, look, let's hop on a call tomorrow. I have a thought that I think you're going to be interested in that I want to run by you. And got on the phone with them, both of them, the next day, and I took the money off the table. I said, hey, if this wasn't about the money, would you be 100% committed
Fuck.
to
Okay.
get your first storage facility, your first cash flowing storage facility? They said, yes, I would. I said, so it's not anything else. If we could figure something out with the money, I don't know that we could, but if we could, you guys would be 100% on board. So took them through that whole process,
I'm loving it. I'm loving this. Thank you.
and it was so. Anyways, got the sale this morning. What I've been doing all these sales calls for the last several months that I'm going to switch and no longer do is if I feel good about the call and I think I'm going to get them as a client, even though it's an I'll think about it and we'll connect tomorrow, I'm not introducing financing. That's not working for me. What I'm now going to do is if I ever get the I'll think about it, I'm going to take the money off the table. I'll just say, hey, be honest with me. It's about the money, isn't it? I'll take the money off the
It's always
table.
about the money, by the way.
Yeah. But I think what I've, if I think I can get somebody to pay in full, I've been waiting the 24 hours to reconnect with them, and that's not really working out. So anytime now I hear the I'll think about it, I'll basically go through the whole process, offer some type of financing, and just try to close it on the spot.
That's great. Round of applause for Alex. My mentor used to
So,
always say, my mentor
Claude,
used to always, my
can I ask
mentor.
a question? So, Alex, so you
Sure.
know if they have that you basically discuss the money right there about take the money off the table, not like let me think about it. You basically then present that and pivot to that.
Correct. That's what I'm starting to do now based on past results, but I haven't been doing that. If they say I want to think about it, I'll just basically introduce some scarcity and urgency. I'll reschedule a shorter call for the next day. But
Right.
9 out of 10 times, that doesn't pan out anyway. So if I ever hear, I'll think about it, even though I felt good about the call and they're qualified and they've gone through the whole process, I'm just gonna like be very direct, say it's about the money, isn't it? Get them to agree, take the money off the table, get them committed, then bring it back in with some type of financing.
That's
That's
great.
great.
Tanya, does that kind of answer your question from before? Alex has a different style than me, but he's using the same psychology of scarcity and authority.
Well,
Different.
scarcity and authority was fine. It was the negative emotion
It was, yeah. It
that got me on your
yeah.
video.
That's more of an anomaly than a day-to-day thing, actually. And maybe I was a little over the top. My bad. The thing about it is, if you're going to lose the sale anyway, and this is what Alex did, if you know you're going to lose the sale anyway, what have you got to lose by being a little bit more daring, a little bit, aggressive in the situation? He did it differently than me, which is fine. It worked. Who cares what you do as long as it works? He actually, how many of us would call back somebody who rejected us? I always talk about, the salesperson comes first. Okay. How much of our ego, our id, our superego, all that good Freud stuff, how much of our confidence is involved in success? How many of us would call somebody back that hung up on us or ghosted us or just said, I don't have the money? How many of us would call that person back? It takes guts. doesn't it, to be successful in this business? It really does. So you know what? The thing about it is, if you're going to lose somebody anyway, just go for it. Alex, I love what you did. You know, here's the rule for you guys. If you're writing, it's over when you say it's over. I believe in the rights of the salesperson in this business. Okay, a little bit different take on it. I believe that we have rights. We're doing business honestly, ethically. We're giving good value. I think we have rights to say when it's over. We can go back to somebody else instead of just bailing out all the time. Do we bail? Do you think sometimes, Alex, you might want to touch on this, and then I'll go back to Wade. I'll go to Wade. Do you think sometimes we give up a little too easily?
Yeah, 100%. I've been guilty of that.
I think we all have. How dramatically has your business increased over the last 60 days?
Yeah, it's been a lot. I've just been more conscious of using the psychology, using the influence, just a lot of things that in the past I would have been like, okay, think about it. And then it becomes a follow-up for weeks and weeks, which never goes anywhere anyways. So now I think I'm just being a little bit more bold and direct while still, you know, maintaining like my personality, my style.
Tanya.
So what could Alex do if he's got someone who's pretty interested and then ghosts him? What would you do to try to get them to re-engage?
Alex?
I would go negative. And what I mean by negative is I'd pull away. You know, I'd basically say, hey, look, you know, now that it's over, you know, you said you wanted X, Y, Z, but now that it's over, what is it you're going to do? Something along those lines, but I wouldn't, the bottom line is I wouldn't chase them. I would pull away.
What happened?
Taking your phone call, they're not answering your calls. I mean, like, how do we get them re-engaged?
Yeah. So, I mean, one of the ways that I've done it and I've, it,